Hello. What I'm going to do in this tutorial is one that I had a suggestion for the other day, which is I'm going to demonstrate how to create a light switch for your interior. So I'm in the interior cell that I made for my last tutorial, the key card one, and I've made it instead of having a default light in, it's got this kind of dark light in, and all I've done to get that is I've gone to my interior, right click, edit, go to lighting, and I've just selected default lighting template far. It doesn't really make that much of a difference for tutorial. It just looks like this. And to get it to look like how it will look in the as close to an approximation as you can look in the game as possible. So your editor might look like this. Press A to turn off a light, press 6 to turn on the sky. And that's as close to what it's going to look like in the game as it's sort of capable of demonstrating. So now I'm going to put some lights in. So I'm going to put in a warm light. I'm going to put in default warm 02, no shadow. Don't see it makes a difference for the tutorial. That's just what it's going to look like. I do have a more detailed tutorial on lighting, but for now I'm just going to click and drag some basic lights in. So I'm just going to duplicate that one and put a light in the other room as well. Save that. And next, what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to put in an X marker. So I'm going to go to the static section. Get rid of my filter for that. And then I'm going to click and drag in this X marker here and just have it floating up above the world. I mean, these don't actually appear in game, so you could have it randomly in the room. I'm going to put it up above the world. And next, what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to double click this and I'm going to set it to initially disabled because I'm going to want our lights to be turned off by default. So, okay. Then I'm going to click on that light and control click on that light so they're both highlighted. Then I'm going to press the minus key and that's going to bring up the batch editor here. And none of these will be selected by default, probably. So you're going to want to select enable parent like that, target reference and render window, and double click on this. So to make sure that's gone, just click on it. I think I've missed. Yep. So we're going to click and click again, select and render window. Double click, and then I'm going to press do like that. And now these blue lines are telling us that these are enable parents. This is an enable parent of these. So what this means is these lights are going to share their enabled disabled status with this X marker. So we don't need to set these to be initially disabled because they're sharing that status with this X marker, which is initially disabled. And so when we enable this X marker, we're going to simultaneously enable both of these things. So that's really useful as well if you're wanting to enable or disable a large amount of objects in one go. You don't have to manually enable each one individually, and you also don't have to manually set the enable parent individually because you can use the batch editor to do them all in one go. So now we're going to want to actually add in our button. So our button is going to be an activator, and I thought that toggle button would work best for this, just how it looks. But any button will do, but I kind of thought this had the vaguely light switchy look to it. So I'm going to put that in like that. And then I'm going to double click on it. And you can see there's already a script here, and we're going to leave this here because this just handles making the button like animate and press in and out. And we don't actually want to change any of that. So we're going to want to add a new script instead. So I'm going to hit new script. Okay, get rid of that constant thing. We're going to want it to be a conditional script, and we're going to want to give it a unique name. So I'm just going to call it tutorial light switch script. Should do. Okay. And these are going to pop up, but we're just going to cancel those. So I'm going to right click on the script we just added, edit source, and we're going to type in our script. So first things first, I'm going to make two properties. I'm going to make an object reference. So I spell that right, reference property of any name that we want, as long as it's unique within this script. Auto const, because we're going to want it to be constant, we're not going to want to change it. And then I'm going to go int property status auto conditional. And that's why we wanted to make the script conditional, because if we make the script constant, we wouldn't be able to define a conditional variable. And this variable status, we're going to use to control whether the lights are on or off. Because they're off by default, we're going to leave it at 0. And but yeah, that makes sense. So now we're going to make the actual event. So I'm going to type event on activate, and then open brackets, object reference, action ref. And I think you can call this whatever you want, but I always call it the name that it is in the syntax in the documentation and other wiki and stuff like that, basically. So this is the object reference which does the activating, and we're going to use that to check that only the player can activate this button. So if action ref, i.e. the object reference that's activating this button, equals game.get player, open brackets, close brackets. So basically, if the player activates it, then I'm going to put if status equals zero, i.e. if it's off, then light marker, which is the object reference that we've defined up here at the top, dot enable. And then I'm going to put status equals one. So basically, if the player activates it, if status equals zero, our light marker is going to enable, and then it's going to set status to one. So else if, and we probably don't need to do an else if because it's mutually exclusive, but I'm just going to do else if status equals one, light marker dot disable status equals zero. End if end event. So we're just ending our two if statements and then ending the actual event to see if I've done it right. Yes, I've done. So yeah, so basically I'll run through it once more. So when the button is activated, if the object reference which is doing the activating, so actionRef equals game.getPlayer, it'll then run this set of checks. So if status is zero, i.e. we haven't got the lights turned on, it will turn the lights on and it will set status to one to track the fact that the lights are turned on. If status equals one, on the other hand, which it will do if we've turned the lights on earlier, then the lights are going to be disabled and status is going to be set to zero, i.e. the lights are turned off, which will mean you can then turn them on. And then we just end that if statement, end event, close. But at the moment, that's not enough because we actually haven't assigned our property to anything. So we're now going to want to edit the properties. And you can see our status variable has defaulted to zero because we haven't defined anything there, which is what we wanted. But our light marker has defaulted to none. So I'm going to double click it, pick reference and render window, and we're going to pick this X marker to be our light marker. So now this will be enabled and disabled based on the pressing of this button. And as we saw at the beginning, that is then going to trigger these to also enable and disable. So that is basically all there is to it. So what I'm going to do now is just go into the game and demonstrate how that works. Okay, so here I am in our interior, and it's dark, as I said in the video, because we had them to be disabled by default. But we can press this button, and the lights turn on. And if we press the button again, rather than dismissing a message, then the lights will turn off. So we can just keep on and on doing that now. It's just going to switch between the on and off state over and over. And that's basically all there is to it. So hopefully that was useful. Hopefully that was clear. Thank you for watching and goodbye.